Hello everyone, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to share some summer hairstyles. Make sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell, and let me know in the comments which of the three hairstyles is your favorite, and let's get started. To start the first hairstyle, I'm going to have my part on the right side. Then I'm going to pick up a section on the heavy side of the part and divide it into three smaller pieces for my braid. Since I'm doing a French braid, I'm going to be crossing both side strands over the middle strand. Then I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair. So I'm crossing the right strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over and into the middle strand. Then I'm going to cross the left strand over the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it over, bringing it into the braid as well. Then I'm crossing the right strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and bringing it into the braid. Then I'm crossing the left strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair, crossing it over and into the middle strand as well. And I'm going to repeat those steps, crossing the side strands over the middle while incorporating new sections of hair into the braid, working my way down the left side of my head. And once the braid reaches the top of my ear, I'm going to stop bringing in hair on the bottom side of the braid and only incorporate hair to the top side of the braid from the top of my head. So I'm still crossing the side strands over the middle strand while bringing in new sections of hair to the top side of the braid from along the top of my head. And I'm going to continue this pattern, working my way down until I've brought in hair at the nape of my neck. Once the braid reaches the nape of my neck, I'm going to bring the braid underneath the rest of the hair and then divide off a section of hair from the left side of my neck and tie it to the end of the braid using a clear elastic band. And then I'm going to let the rest of the hair hang over the top of the braid to finish off the side swoop style. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to begin with my hair parted on the right side. Then I'm going to divide off the crown section of hair to create a little bit of volume for the style. And then I'm going to pin it at the back of my head using a bobby pin. Now I'm going to pick up a section of hair on the heavy side of the part to use for my braid. And I'm going to divide this into two sections. Since I'm creating a rope or twist style braid, I'm going to begin by crossing the left strand over the right strand. Then I'm going to pick up a section of hair and add it into the right section. Then I'm going to pick up a section of hair on the left side and add it into the left section. Then I'm going to cross the left strand over the right strand and repeat this pattern, working my way down the left side of my head. So I'm picking up a new section of hair on the right side and adding it into the right side section. Then I'm going to pick up another section on the left side and add it into the left side section. I'm also going to be twisting both of the sections towards my face before crossing the left strand over the right strand again. And I'm going to repeat those steps, creating the rope braid along the left side of my head using the hair that I left down from the crown section. So I'm still crossing the left strand over the right strand while also picking up new sections of hair from my head and incorporating them into each side section before twisting the left side strand over the right strand. Once the braid reaches the back of my head near the center, I'm going to stop bringing in new sections of hair and just continue the rope braid, working my way down to the ends of the section. So I'm still crossing the left strand over the right strand while twisting each section towards my face. Then once the braid reaches the bottom, I'm going to use a clear elastic band and tie off the end of the braid. Now I'm going to create another twist or rope braid on the right side of my head using the hair on this side. So again, I'm picking up a section near the part and I'm going to divide the hair into two pieces. I'm crossing the right strand over the left strand and then I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. So I'm picking up a section on the left side of the braid and I'm adding it into the left section. Then I'm picking up a section on the right side, adding it into the right side section, and then crossing the right strand over the left. And as I work my way down the section, I'm also going to be twisting each section towards my face, twisting each of the sections in the opposite direction that they're being wrapped. This is what helps hold the braid in place, since the hair is simply being twisted around each other. So I'm going to repeat those steps, crossing the right strand over the left strand while incorporating new sections of hair into each side section. And I'm creating the braid down the right side of my head
bringing in all of the hair until it reaches the back of my neck. And then I'm going to continue the braid down to the ends, crossing one side over the other. And once the braid reaches the bottom, I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the end of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to take each braid and wrap them up the sides of my head. So I'm bringing the left braid up the right side and the right braid up the left side. And I'm going to cross the braids over the top of my head. And then I'm going to pin them in place with some bobby pins. So I like to slide my pins into the center of the braids and then angle them along the braid so they stay hidden underneath the hair. And I just kept pinning until they felt nice and secure and weren't going to fall loose. For the next hairstyle, I've got my hair parted on the right side again. Then I'm going to divide off a section of hair at the crown of my head and pin it at the back using a couple bobby pins. This will help add some volume to the hairstyle. And I'm also going to pinch and pull on small pieces so they slide out of the bobby pins to create some texture to the style. Now I'm going to divide off a section of hair on the right side in front of the crown section and gently twist this hair together. Laying it over the bobby pins from the crown section, I'm going to pin it in place at the back of my head. Then I'm going to go back over the twist and carefully pull on the bottom just to loosen up the twist so it drapes a little bit and looks more soft. Then I'm going to divide off a similar sized section on the left side of the crown, and I'm going to bring this underneath the previous section. And I'm twisting the hair slightly upwards as well, and then using a bobby pin, I'm going to pin the section on the right side of my head. Then, of course, I'm going to go back over the twist and gently pull on small sections to loosen the twist and make the style a little bit softer. Now I'm going to go back to the right side of my head and divide off another section of hair a little bit closer to my face. And I'm going to twist this section around towards the back of my head. I'm twisting the hair upwards and I'm going to lay the twist underneath the previous two twists. And I'm going to take some bobby pins and pin the hair in place. I'm placing my pins in the center of the twist, gripping a bit of hair so they hold the twist without the bobby pin showing. And then I'm going to place a final bobby pin on the left side, sliding it along the twist so it stays hidden underneath the hair. And once it feels nice and secure, I can go back over the hair and pull on small sections to make the twist a little bit fuller and softer and hide any gaps in between the previous twists. Now I'm going to take my final section of hair on the left side of my head and repeat the same steps as before, twisting the hair upwards, draping the twist around the back of my head underneath the previous twists. And then I'm just going to pin it in place using some more bobby pins. And then I can go back over the twists and gently pull on small sections to help soften them. And now I'm going to create a French braid using the rest of my hair. So I'm picking up a section of hair right underneath the twists at the back of my head, and I'm going to divide this into three pieces for my braid. I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand, and then I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. So I'm crossing the side strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair, bringing it into the braid, crossing it over the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the other side strand over the middle, picking up another section of hair from the side of my head, crossing it over the middle strand, bringing it into the braid as well. And I'm going to incorporate new sections of hair into the braid until the rest of the hair left out is all brought in. So I'm continuing the French braid, working my way down the back of my head, crossing the side strands over the middle strand. So I'm crossing the side strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair, bringing it into the braid, crossing it over the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the other side strand over the middle, picking up another section of hair from the side of my head, crossing it over the middle strand, bringing it into the braid as well. And I only wanted the braid to go about halfway to 3/4 of the way down. So I'm going to take one of the side strands and wrap it around the end of the braid. And then I'm going to take an elastic band and tie this over the bottom, making sure to include the ends from the wrapped piece. And this will hold the braid in place while also hiding the elastic band. So now I'm going to go back over the braid and carefully pull on the center pieces of the braid. This is the best way to make a French braid look a little bit fuller. So I'm going to pull on the initial three strands that are wrapped down the center of the braid to make the braid look a little bit wider. and the overall style a little bit softer.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Be sure to let me know in the comment section which of the hairstyles was your favorite. I love knowing which one is the favorite so that I can film more of those in the future. Be sure to like and subscribe if you haven't already and click that notification bell, then you'll never miss any future uploads. And I will see you next time.